We do the road safety campaign twice a year. And every year we ask ourselves, is this doing any good? The goal is to try and reach zero accidents. Probably almost impossible, but you got to have a goal. And that continues to be ours. We can say that the progress made by these road safety campaigns has helped to lower the statistics in UNMIL, but still not enough. The theme this year, creating awareness on prevailing road conditions to reduce accidents, start early, drive carefully, live and save lives. I appreciate that many of you who have zero accident rates will receive certificates today. We'll have a number of skits that are put on by various groups that have shown an interest in what we're doing. But I would encourage all of you that as we finish today's opening ceremony and you leave and go out amongst your colleagues, you don't leave those ideas and the presentations that have focused on key points only here in today's ceremony, but you take it with you and you talk about it and share it. But the message is one that we have to continue to try and get across to our fellow staff. People still joke about drinking and driving, unfortunately. They still joke about using mobile phones when they're in a vehicle. We still find people driving too fast, waiting until the last minute to go to a meeting, to take a trip. We still have not embraced those areas that are key of this year's theme. And a lot of that involves how we address road traffic conditions based on the conditions of the road. I encourage you that as you go back to work, think about the messages that are here today. Remember, the life you save could be your own. Once you're behind the wheel of that vehicle, it's a completely different world that you are facing. And we need everyone to do their part to try and both save the equipment that we've got, but also save each other, whether in Liberia or other places in the world, a safer environment for all of us.
It has always been a big challenge to keep track on drivers' behavior on the road, especially considering the conditions of roads that we operate on day by day. Although UNMIL vehicles are in good roadworthy conditions, we equally need drivers with good driving skills to operate them. It has always been our target to sensitize, educate all personnel driving UNMIL vehicles by raising the bar of our training materials, which in effect has gradually reduced major traffic accidents or incidents to date. This year, road safety wouldn't be where it is today without all of your hard work and your support, especially those of you here today to receive certificates in recognition of your safe driving ability and skills. We thank you all.
From tomorrow, 16th of June, we will have road speed checks with LMP and AMPOL. And we will have outreach program, LMP and AMPOL, at LY Junction. For the military, on 17th of June, there will be prevention of road traffic accident and case study demonstrated by Ghanaian COE. On 18th of June, prevention of road traffic accident and case study by Chinese TPT unit. And on 19th of June, prevention of road traffic accident and case study by NIBAT 35. As far as outreach program goes, on 15th of June, which is today, this morning, they had, UNPOL had at 10 o'clock at Red Light Market area. Tomorrow, 10 o'clock in the morning, outreach program at LY Junction. 17th of June, at 10 o'clock in the morning, outreach program at Vamoma Junction. 18 June, same time as always, outreach program, Waterside Market. And on 19th of June, outreach program at 10 o'clock, Douala Market. Now I will move to the program the transport has prepared for you for this week. Tomorrow we will deliver the lessons at SKD Stadium for, I believe it's Naibat 35, after all terrain. In the afternoon, we will have a briefing session with AMPOL at our TPT conference room here at Starbase from 4 o'clock. 17th of June, we will have another session with AMPOL from 4 to 5. On Thursday, we will be delivering lessons at Camp Abuja. In the afternoon, we will have lessons for AMPOL, and in the meantime, we will have, if anybody is interested, you are welcome for defensive driving training. 19th of June, we will be delivering lessons at Nepali FPU, and in the afternoon, we will have lessons for AMPOL in our TPT conference room. If you want to see this or want to know what is happening in our regions, please go to the broadcast. It's there for everybody.
First of all, I have to say it's a pleasure to be here today.
Thank you.
As second time in Liberia, and it's really the first time with the traffic safety day. So I think it's a very good initiative, and I really appreciate it for all of us in the leadership team. We have an excellent cooperation with the Liberian National Police. We have been advising and training for many, many years in all around the country. So we'll see a lot of improvement, but be careful. I had to write down some small note to remember all I should say, because as we know, in UN missions, the challenge is driving and driving safely. So just a few small advice to all of us here, but also to the rest of the UN family all around in the country and all for UN mission. Do not speed. Do not drive under influence of alcohol. Do not drive when tired. Anticipate hazard. Keep your vehicle in good condition. And also wear seatbelt. Always. And drive defensive. And take care of the chaotic traffic in Monrovia City and also the bad road condition all around the Cape. All your family, friends and loved ones will have you safe back to your home country. So thank you very much.
On behalf of the force commander and military leadership, to thank all of you most sincerely for being present here. I would want, most importantly, to thank my compatriots from the military who have tried as much as possible to drive within the regulations, despite the fact that we've got a few incidents. I think the essence of this occasion, in actual fact, is for us to get the awareness that there's the need for us to conform to rules at all times. For those who are going to receive these certificates, I don't think it's supposed to end here, but it's just to pep you on to do more. And for us who have not been able to get it for now, we try to get ours in the near future. On this note, I want to thank you all very much. Thank you.
All of the information that we have received here today are very important information that can help us while we drive to our respective localities. And some of those demonstrations that were carried out today, as if though the demonstrators once upon a time saw me in some of those situations, like the one my brother Butini was saying, on Saturday, I drove at a red light to go and collect my wife. On my way driving home, it was raining very, very heavily. And at the same time, the air condition, the AC in my private car had given up. And it was very, very desperate. And I had some other family members who have come to me at home. They were calling me for the family meeting. and I needed to get home at all costs. But again, I could not see ahead of me because of the heavy downpour of rain. So what I did, I politely parked off the road and waited for the rain to stop, then I continued my journey. The best and professional driver is the one that reached to his location and come back. If you take all of the safety tips that have been given you today, that have been provided to you, I think you'll be one of the best operators. Some of us, we do not even check on our drivers. Some of us, our drivers in our present, we come and get in our vehicles. We're all even checking the vehicle because we are rushing. What I usually tell people, if you need to be somewhere at 10 o'clock in the morning, leave your house by 7. You leave your house by 7, 8 o'clock in the morning, you'll be able to get there on time. You will not be driving hurriedly, and you will not be in a rush situation where you will have to break some traffic regulation or traffic rules to get to where you are going in order to avoid accident and what have you. If you are drunk, do not drive. Ask your friend to drive. So, the position I'm in, I'm not in the position to drive. I'm not in the right frame of mind to drive. Will you please help me to drive? That would be better. It will be saving you. It will be saving the next person. If you know that your friend is drunk and he or she cannot drive to where you are going, it is good for you to be on the safe side. Don't tell the man, say, manage it. Or tell the lady, say, manage it. Your management could lead you to hospital or to the great beyond. Okay, the life you save may be your own or that of a loved one or a friend. Sometimes you see some of our driving, we are on cell phones and pedestrians crossing the road, we don't take them into consideration. We knock down the pedestrian and sometimes kill them and sometimes they end up in hospital. If we take all of those safety tips into consideration, I think we'll have a good driving community. Thank you very much.
Sometimes we know we'll get drunk, sometimes we drive, but at least when you know you can't make it, just forget about the car. And I want to say some people will rain falling, they still won't force it because I know some people kept it down, they won't force it. The car must go, curfew will not catch me, I will go. And when you're in the car, the rain falling, you can't see nothing. If you decided to park off the road, don't just park, you leave one full tire on a quota, then you take the other small one, you claim in the sidewalk. Somebody coming to find a way to park. They not see you. The only thing can hear, bah! Which means no park. Go park, go. Hardly so well.
You want to clap for John bigger than that?